Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and welcome back to another episode of our forest playthrough. So yeah, as you can see, our save worked this time. Has that reset? I'm not even sure if it has or not. Yes, it has. Of course it has, because that's a deadfall trap. What about our noose trap? That looks like it's reset as well. So it would appear that traps reset when you load back into the game. Now, one thing I will say is my inventory is either gone or it's just invisible. Not sure which, but yeah, also these trees have come back that we already chopped down as well. Did I just see a lizard? No. But we are going to grab some sticks because we want to build some more traps. Now, I am considering moving location, to be quite honest, because I have a feeling that they're going to be back pretty soon. But first thing we want to do, head up here. Oh, we've just equipped something I didn't want to equip. There we go. So yeah, we've got no Molotovs, we've got no supplies, although we might do. They just might not be showing up. I'm not really sure yet. But first thing we need to do is find some food, because obviously we now have none. Stop equipping things. I think that's a bug with the inventory issue. So yeah, we need to find something to eat. So we're looking for some berries, I guess, basically. Or lizards. Rabbits, anything like that. Is that a lizard over there? Who knows? Maybe. Could just be a rock. Yep, it's just a rock. A little bit worried because one of the mutants got away from us in the last episode. And I'm going to assume that he is going to go and tell his buddies where we are. It also looked like it's the site of a patrol. We're right by one of these big trees, which is a gathering spot for the mutants. So that could well be why they're here. No, we don't want the black-tipped ones, we want the blue ones. Black ones are not good for us at all. So we're going to skip that. But I'm thinking we might have to leave our base and set up somewhere else, because basically I am assuming that they are going to be making a beeline back towards where we've set up. So yeah, I think it might be wise for us to just move on. But then of course that means we've got to set up more traps, a new place to sleep. Isn't that big a deal, but of course it does negate everything that we've done so far. Yep, we've been seen. Okay, this is a problem, so let's see if we can just get away from them. Actually, I wonder if we can make it back home. Maybe. Well, we're going to try it, because we do have traps there. Ooh, loads of suitcases. That could be good. We could find ourselves some food. Of course, I do just want to put some distance between us now. Maybe we'll stay where we are then for this episode. We'll build some more traps, and we're just going to assume that we're going to be under attack. I don't really want to mess around with those guys if they're hunting us. Oh, please tell me I can get back down here. There we go. Okay, we're safe. Hopefully. For now, anyway. So, let's get to work. We're going to start digging down some trees. Keeping an ear out for any of the mutants. But yeah, I'd say it's basically assured that they're going to be coming back. We also didn't find anything to eat, although if things are looking clear, I'm going to head back up to where those suitcases are. And hopefully grab some supplies. So, we need some more traps, basically. So, let's do that now. We're going to set another noose trap right about here, I think. And we need quite a few more logs still. Two more logs. Which I thought might have been around, but obviously not. So, let's chop this tree down. It would appear we've actually given those zombies... Zombies? This isn't Project Zomboid. It appears we've given the mutants the slip. So you can run away from them if you're quick enough. They're not going to track you that well. Of course, with our proximity to that big tree, I do know that they worship those trees, apparently. So, yeah, we're basically right where they're going to be patrolling, which isn't good. But saying that, there we go. Another noose trap is up, and I think we need to get some more built. Surround ourselves completely with these things. I think it might be wise for us to just use this location while we gather some supplies back up. Of course, if we're going to lose our inventory every time we save, that could be a bit of an issue. I mean, essentially, we don't want to be really filling our inventory up with too much, if that's the case. And we are getting really hungry, so we might just have to head back up to those suitcases and hope for the best. Just get this tree chopped down first. Basically, I want to have a lot of traps here, so if we do get into trouble, we can run back here and at least have a fighting chance of survival. Should get some standing fires up as well pretty soon, because they are pretty effective when you're fighting the zombies. I keep saying zombies. They're not zombies. They're effective when you're fighting the mutants, because as long as you fight in their general vicinity, it's entirely possible that the mutants will run into the fire and burn themselves. And of course, without Molotovs, that would be extremely useful to us. And there we go, there's one more. Alright, so we're going to head up and see if we can get ourselves some supplies. We're going to have to be very, very careful about this, though. And if we hear anyone, we've basically just got to run for it. I mean, we could try and fight them off, I guess. I think there was maybe only a couple of them. But I don't know, it could be difficult. Right, so it's near here, right? I can hear frogs. I'm not sure if we can eat frogs or not. But there's definitely some cases around here somewhere. We've definitely got to be very careful in this area, though. I would like to find a spear, if possible. That is the that would be absolutely perfect for us. What the hell was that? What did I just pick up? I don't know. Let's quickly check our inventory. Well, we've got a snack. And we've got some more booze, so that's a start. Now we just need some cloth. Come on. And we can make ourselves... Get away. We can make ourselves some Molotovs. I really wish it would re-equip my axe. When I want it to. That is a rock. Here we go. So this is going to keep us going for a while, but essentially, if we load back in without any inventory, then we're going to have to go and try and find what I'm calling Suitcase Beach. And we were there in, I think, a couple of episodes ago where all the suitcases were. We got any more? Just rocks, sticks, which we're going to grab. So I think that's basically all the supplies we're going to get. Now I am... Whoa, check that out. I am sorely tempted to set up like a fire as a decoy. Like somewhere around here. So we're going to do that. And let's set up a standing fire, I guess. And light that thing up. Now that's not going to stay lit forever. However... any mutants that come around here, hopefully they'll sort of hang around this area instead of bothering us. Let's grab that. See, now this would actually be a really good place to set a base up, because we could essentially wall off this area. If it wasn't for that big tree that attracted them, then we'd be in a pretty good position, really. But anyway, we've got some food. Let's have a look. We've got some booze. Unfortunately, we don't... Can we use... We can't use the leaves. We've got some meds, so we can restore our health, but we have no cloth. So we can't make any more Molotovs, unfortunately. Which is a real shame. But anyway, we roll with the punches, and we take what we can get. And, you know, like I said before, this is just an issue with playing alphas. Hopefully the inventory bug will be fixed. And then we can get into this game proper. I mean, for now, it's not that bad. It gives us a reason to get out there and forage around, I guess. Now, I'm sort of tempted to build a little structure around our base. With a fire out front. We've kind of got enough traps. I am really tempted to put one down right here, though. So that's what we're going to do. Like so. And we need 5 logs. Of course we do. There's 2. So that's a start. Did I just camouflage? Yes, I did. Right, what you can see there is, well, maybe not see very clearly, but we've just covered ourselves in mud. Basically like Arnie in Predator. So that's going to help camouflage us from being seen, which is awesome for us. I think we should maybe light our fire. A little bit worried that it's going to draw the attention of some muties, though, so I guess we'll leave it right now. So I apologize if this is a bit dark. Usually I do try and lighten things up in the edit, as I'm sure you've seen. I do have brightness turned up as well, so hopefully it's not too bad. I can still kind of see, so I hope you can. It's basically, it's not nighttime yet, but it's certainly on the way. So once we've got this trap set up, I'm going to place down some blueprints. I'm not going to start building them because I'm probably going to save, and I think we're coming up on 20 minutes on the episode now anyway, so I will probably save after I've built this trap. But we'll build some blueprints. Now, as I understand it, they're going to vanish anyway, but we can get a sort of good look at how I want this little shack to be. And it's only temporary, so, you know. It is what it is. Oh, we better avoid all this stuff. I think we can actually set our own traps off, which would be very bad. Don't mind dying to mutants, but obviously we don't want to die to our own hand. Okay, so. And it's getting really dark. Let's just risk the fire. And we'll stoke it up a bit. So, now I want to find... Custom building. So, custom building with a door, which I don't seem to be able to click. Seriously, why can't I build it? Now that's weird, and I can't even select defensive wall. So, we're talking that. That's what we've got to work with right now. So, I would stick that there. And then another one right alongside it. And so forth till we get down to the water's edge. But anyway, I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. What I will do is I will save the game as soon as I'm done recording, I will save the game. But yeah, I'm going to call this the end. So as always, I really hope you've enjoyed watching this episode of The Forest. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more. Peace.